we discuss the behavior of a sequence. A sequence may converge or diverge or oscillate. What is the definition of convergent sequence? We say a sequence AN is said to converge to a real number L. That L may be positive or negative or even zero if for a given epsilon greater than zero. We know that the value of epsilon is very, very, very small, but it must be positive. So we say that however small, epsilon is however small. For example, epsilon value may be 0.001 or 0.000005 or 0.10008. Very small value, but it must be more than zero. It must be greater than zero. Then there exists a natural number M. And this natural number M depends upon epsilon. That means if epsilon value changes, M value also changes, such that modulus of An minus L is less than epsilon for all N greater than or equals to M. We know that modulus of An minus L less than epsilon. Let us remove the modulus. Then by inequality, minus epsilon less than An minus L less than plus epsilon. Now adding L, then we get L minus epsilon less than An less than L plus epsilon. Therefore, now this modulus of An minus L less than epsilon can be written as L minus epsilon less than An less than L plus epsilon for all N is greater than or equals to M. When you say N is greater than or equal to M, what does it mean? That is, from Mth term onwards, from Mth term onwards, all the value of the sequence must lie between L minus epsilon and L plus epsilon. We can also define convergence of a sequence in terms of limit. That is, if limit of the nth term of the sequence An as n tends to infinity is L, then we say that the sequence An converges to L, or the sequence An is convergent. Now the important thing is, when you say N is greater than or equal to M, what does it mean? Now we will discuss with an example. Consider the example number one, the sequence An, which is equal to N by N plus 1, whose terms are, when you keep N equal to 1, we get 1 by 2, keep N equal to 2, we get the second term, namely 2 by 3, so on. So the first term is 1 by 2, second term is 2 by 3, third term is 3 by 4, so on. And hence A1 is the first term whose value is 1 by 2, that is nothing but 0.5. A2 is 0.6666. Then A1000, that is the 1000th term of the sequence, is 0.999000999001. When you come to the 10 lakhs term, the 10 lakhs term, A suffix 10 lakhs, whose value is 0.999999000001, which is at most is equals to 1, nearly equal to 1. Therefore, now we say that the limit is 1. The sequence is convergent and converges to 1. Now here, we know that from the 10 lakhs term onwards, the value of the sequence is very, very, very close to 1. Therefore, what we do is, we take M is equals to 10 lakhs. In the definition, we say n is greater than or equal to m. What is m? 10 lakhs. Therefore, from 10 lakhs term onwards, the sequence an equal to n by n plus 1 gives the value 1. This you can see in the diagram itself. Look at this here, a1, a2, a3, so on. So when it goes the value, when the values are increased, then the values of the sequence is almost equals to 1. We can also take limit. We take limit, take n out from the denominator, n cancel. When you apply limit, we get 1. This way also, we can get the answer. Okay, now, look at the diagrams. All the things are coming to only one place. Here, look at the rays. All the rays, after passing through the convex lens, getting focused to one point. That point is the convergent point. That is the limit of the sequence, we say. So here, all the values from AM onwards, AM, AM plus 1, AM plus 2, so on, all the values are coming closer to the value L. And this value L is the limit. This is another one, is another example. See here, from different places, all are coming to one place. After some time, it has come to one place. That place is the value of the sequence or convergent. What is the geometrical representation? Geometrically, a sequence AN converges to L means, as we discussed, from mth term and after mth term, that is for all n is greater than or equal to m. That's the one. From mth term and after mth term, every term in the sequence must lie between the strip L minus epsilon and L plus epsilon. Convergence of a sequence means for large value of n. We discussed one example just now. There the value was 10 lakhs. The terms of the sequence will be very, very close to L. The number L is called your limit of a sequence. That means for a sequence, we can have more than one limit. The limit L need not be a member of the sequence. Now consider the diagram here. Here we take first one, n equal to 1. That is first term A1, n equal to 2. Then the second term A2, n equal to 3. The third term is A3. So on, n equal to 4, we have A4. Now so on, we continue. Let us come to M minus 1. M minus 1 somewhere here. Now what is mth term? Mth term is important for us. Whose value is AM? What is, suppose we consider the thin line as L and these two dotted lines as L minus epsilon and L plus epsilon. As per the definition, what happened? All the values of the sequence from mth term onwards must lie between the strip L minus epsilon and L plus epsilon. Therefore, if you consider mth term, AM is between these two strips. What about AM plus 1? There is M plus 1 term. It is also between the strip. What about AM plus 2? It is also in the strip. So after that, every value, dot, 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 see here, M, M plus 1, M plus 2, dot, dot, dot. All the values of the sequence must lie between the strip, L minus epsilon and L plus epsilon. See here. Whereas other values like A3, A4, A5, they need not belong to the strip. Here A2, A5 are there. But what about A3? Outside. What about AM minus 1? Outside the strip. But from mth term onwards, every term in the sequence must lie between L minus epsilon, L plus epsilon. That is, the values is very, very close to L. And hence, we say that the sequence AN converges to L. So we say geometrically, a sequence AN converges to L means from mth term and after mth term. See here, m, m plus 1, m plus 2, so on. Every term in the sequence must lie between the strip L minus epsilon and L plus epsilon. See here, everything must be here only. Now, this is an example. Here, look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4. After this, all the values are between the strip L plus epsilon and L minus epsilon. If you consider the example of the sequence AN, that is equal to N plus 1 by N squared. After some terms, what happened? The value is, see here, A1 is just, it is 2. A2 is 3 by 4. A3 is this value, is 4 by 9, so on. After some time, what happens here? From 20th term onwards here, it is almost equal to 0. Therefore, we say the limit of the sequence AN is 0, or we say that AN converges to 0. This example just now we discussed. This is a picture of the previous case, namely the example an equal to n by n plus 1. See here, after some times, after some terms, all will be equal to 1. This is the one, you can see thickness here. You can see thickness. All the values of the sequence is at most 1. Now consider another example, sequence 1 by n. Whose values are 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, this sequence converges to 0. We can simply take the limit of the sequence. Look at this, limit of 1 by n as n tends to infinity equal to 0. If you want to find the convergent of a sequence, simply take a limit. Apply limit as n tends to infinity. Whatever value you get, that value is a convergent of that sequence. Consider sequence AN whose nth term is n plus 2 by 2n minus 1. As we discussed in the previous case, A1 is 3. Second term is 4 by 3. A3 is 1. See, the values are decreasing. A1000 is 0.501250601. So on. What about A10 lakhs? It is 0.500001250006. It is at most is equal to 0.5. And hence we say that the limit of the sequence n plus 2 by 2n minus 1 is 0.5. Hence we say that the sequence converges to 0.5 or 1 by 2. These are some examples. See here the values A1, A2, A3, so on. After some time, it comes to L. Here also same thing. Here is oscillating. But finally, what happened? After some time, it comes to L. This is another example. These are all diagrams which shows the convergence of some of the sequences. Now, consider the example of this function n plus 1 by n squared. As we discussed here, see here a1, a2, a3, after some time it converges to 0. This value is 0, that's nothing but here. This is a graphical representation of the sequence. Now, the second part of behavior of your sequence, that is divergent. We have two types of divergent. One is diverges to plus infinity, another is diverges to minus infinity. What is diverges to plus infinity? A sequence is said to diverge to plus infinity if for a given positive real number k, however large, it can be highest value, maybe 10 crore or more. There exists M belongs to N. And this M depends upon K, as in the case of convergent. Convergent, in the case of convergent, that M depends upon epsilon. Whereas here, in the case of diverges to plus infinity, m depends upon the value of k. Because as k changes, the value of m also changes, such that an, that is the nth term of the sequence, is more than k. From when? From m onwards. From mth term onwards, every term in the sequence must be more than k. In this case, we say that the sequence is diverges to plus infinity. The sequence diverges to plus infinity. Symbolically, it can be written as limit of an as n tends to infinity is plus. Or we say an tends to infinity as n tends to infinity. Consider the example. Very simple example. An equal to n. This represents all the natural numbers. The sequence n diverges to plus infinity because for a given k, however large, we can find m. Such that what happened? An is always greater than k for all n greater than or equal to m. Similarly, the sequence 2n plus 3, whose terms are 5, 7, 9, 11, so on. What's the last value? We don't know. It goes on. So this series sequence also diverges to plus infinity. See the difference between bounded below and diverges to plus infinity. In the case of bounded below sequence, an is greater than or equals to k for all n. It is right from the first term. Right from the first term, it must satisfy. Here it is greater than or equal to m. In the case of diverges to plus infinity, it is strictly greater than k because it may not be equal to k. From when? From mth term onwards. What about the terms a1, a2, a minus 1? What happened? It may not be true. But from mth term onwards, every term must be more than this value k. If k is 1 lakh, then am term must be more than 1 lakh. So the difference here is, in bounded below, we have greater than or equal to symbol. In diverges to plus infinity, we have simply greater than symbol. Here in bounded below, it must be true for every term, right from the first term to the last term of the sequence, it must be true. But here in diverges to plus infinity, from mth term onwards, this inequality is true. Another example, same example. Say an equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, n. The sequence n diverges to plus infinity because for a given k, however large, there exists m belongs to n. Such that an is greater than k for all n greater or equal to m. This is a definition. In particular, if we take k is 50,000, then what about this? There exists m, which is 50,001, belongs to a natural number, such that am plus 1, so on, is greater than the 50,000. Look at this here, am plus 1, so on. These are all more than 50. What is k? K is 50,000. So the value of am plus 1, so on, they are all more than 50,000 plus 1. Therefore, we say that the sequence is divergent and diverges to plus infinity. What about diverges to minus infinity? Only two changes. What are they? In diverges to plus infinity, the k is positive real number, however large. But here it is however small. Other one is the nth term is greater than 0 in diverges to plus infinity. Whereas here it is less than k. k for all n greater than or equal to m. So the definition of diverges to minus infinity is a sequence is said to diverge to infinity, minus infinity, if for a given k, k belongs to negative real number or negative value, however small there exists m belongs to n, and this m depends upon k, such that an is less than k for all n greater than or equal to m. That is, from mth term onwards, the sequence must be less than the small value k. Symbolically, it can be written as limit of an as n tends to infinity is minus infinity, or we say an tends to minus infinity as n tends to infinity. The example is very simple example. In the case of diverges to plus infinity, we took the sequence as n. Now for diverges to minus infinity, we take the sequence as minus n. Very simple it is. Now when you say the nth term an is minus n, then the sequence will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on. The sequence minus n diverges to minus infinity because we can get a value k, however small. There exists m belongs to n, such that an is less than k for all n greater than or equal to m. The sequences, namely minus n squared, minus 2 power n, the nth term 2n minus n squared, all diverge to minus infinity. Again, just we recall the definition of bounded above sequence and diverges to minus infinity. The only thing is, here it is less than or equal. Here it is true from mth term onwards. Whereas in bounded above, it is true for every term. Right from the first term, it is same as diverges to plus infinity. Now, what is a diverge sequence? We say a sequence is divergent if it is either diverges to plus infinity or diverges to minus infinity. That is, a sequence which diverges to plus infinity or diverges to minus infinity is said to be a divergent sequence. Look at this here. The values are scattering. It goes to minus plus infinity this side, whereas this side it is goes to minus infinity. Some more examples. We can see here. These are all diverges. All these are diverges to plus infinity. This side is minus infinity. Here also, all the things are scattering. Now, this is the one we took example for convergent sequence. We call all the rays after passing through the convex lens getting focused to F. Whereas here, what happened? From F, it is just scattering. So, therefore, this is convergent, this is divergent. So when you say convergent, the limit must be a real number. It has to give only one value. When you take limit, it has to give only one value. But here what happened? When you take the limit is either plus infinity or minus infinity. So these are all some graphical representation of divergent sequence. Just we compare this. Already we have discussed in the previous slides. Comparison between bounded above diverges to plus infinity. Similarly, bounded below diverges to minus infinity. So from this we say every divergent sequence is unbounded.